Strategically vital to the Battle of Britain, Duxford Airfield now hosts a collection of 200 vintage military and civilian airplanes and vehicles. Maintained by both the Imperial War Museum and Duxford Aviation Society, chairman of the latter is David Hands.
We've been here over 40 years, and obviously we have accumulated a mass of equipment and spares. We have various parts from aircraft. We have aircraft memorabilia, posters, all sorts of different things aviation related, all of which may be of interest to Drew. Hello.
How are you doing?
Pleased to meet you.
Drew, nice to meet you.
David.
Hi, I'm T.
Hi, T.
All right, how are we doing?
Yeah. Shall we have the full tour, please?
Welcome to Duxford.
Thank you very much.
And let me show you around.
Pleasure to be here.
It already looks amazing, doesn't it?
I would love to have a bit of Concorde.
We'll have a look in here, because this is where you're more than likely to find anything from Concorde, any small bits.
What's that say?
That says Cambrian.
Like an Cambrian Airways?
Yes, which was the Viscount came from Cambrian Airways, so it was in Cambrian Airways livery when we got it.
Yeah.
And we got the signs came with it, yeah.
So everything's for sale in here?
Everything's for sale in here, yes.
These two black text on orange background signs with a modernist dragon motif were made from plastic in 1972 for Cambrian Airways. Founded in 1935, Cambrian was the first ever Welsh airline. But in the mid-70s, it closed as one of four companies that merged to form British Airways. Sold together, the signs could be worth around £300.
How much did you want for those?
50 each.
Love those. Right. The two large plastic Cambrian Airways signs, just a good colour. Prop them up in the shop, hang them up. They're not worth a great deal of money, but they are interesting and they're different and they're bright and they're big and it's what I need. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, now you're talking. These are great. They're very 70s, aren't they? But
yeah.
So can you date stuff quite accurately from the logos?
Yes, yeah. and the colours.
Oh, OK.
Yeah, because they had different logos. Obviously, you've got three there. You've got BOAC, BEA, then British Airways. So they're all different eras.
I think these bags all go back to the late 60s, early 70s. And, again, they're very much a time in space. You know, they are that funny little thing you'd get given when you went on the plane because it was such a big deal, you know. Now everybody just jumps on and off planes all the time.
What sort of price are these things?
Probably, I don't know, 25 quid.
So if I'd like that one, BOAC, BOAC. This is a little gold mine, isn't it?
Yeah. What did we say, 25 each?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
So it's three there.
Yeah.
Just really saleable. Very, very saleable things. You're not going to make fortunes out of them, but they're very saleable.
What have you got in here?
In the cupboard?
Anything in
there?
I
don't know. Just have a look in there, see if there's anything in there.
Oh, really?
Engineers overalls.
Concorde
engineers
overalls.
Yeah.
And they're for sale?
Yes.
Well,
this is what you're after, isn't
it? That's exactly what we came here for. They're like new as well, aren't they?
Yeah.
I came here today wanting to buy a bit of Concorde, a bit of British history. Well, have we hit the nail on the head? Concorde engineers overalls. Unused with Concorde on the back. Boom.
Cotton Concorde overalls like this set were specially designed without external pockets to prevent anything falling out of them into the airplane's supersonic air inlets. Original, unworn, and embroidered with the Concorde name, the overalls could be worth around £400.
Do you have a figure in mind? Because I've never bought a pair of overalls from Concorde before.
No.
Be a guesstimate, wouldn't it?
Yeah, I mean, would 100 be too much?
No, 100 would be fine. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. Yeah. I'm going to give you 150 quid.
Right.
Because I think they could do quite well.
Right.
And if I do sell them, and we do make a killing on them, I'll make a nice donation to you. How's that?
Thank you very much.
No, thank you very much. I'm very privileged to own those. Yeah. That's a good one, isn't it, AC?
It is, spot on.
That's nice, exactly what we're after. Bit of history there. Yeah. When Britain was great, I think they're incredibly saleable. I really do. you have to remember just how iconic that plane is and what it meant and what it did. You know, so any little bit of it is also sprinkled with that gold dust that is Concorde.
Supersonic item secured, Drew moves on.
Ah, now, is this where you're preparing stuff for sale?
Some of it, yeah, but unfortunately not these engine panels.
What about these over here?
Yeah, they're just to do with the BAC 111, the flow of fluids.
It's just a really interesting piece of wall art. So what age would that be?
Well, the BAC 111 was 1980s.
For sale?
Yes, definitely.
There's two large sort of teaching aid displays for electrical systems, fuel pressure and water pressure systems, I think, and then one for of a whole plane. Just really saleable. Super, super saleable things.
I would think from the condition of them, probably £100 for the two.
OK, well, we're going to do it again. We're going to give you £300 for the two. How's that?
Thank you.
They're just, you know, that's what I'm comfortable with.
Yeah.
And I just think this place is a marvel.
Right, OK.
They'll go the first week they're in the shop, those.
Really?
Yeah, you straight away.
OK.
They'll fly out. I'd say at least once.
That's not bad, 3 o'clock.
Yeah, that's
Oh, he's been winging it all day.
Hey,
come on.
Hoping for yet more success, Drew's heading for Duxford's final storage container.
Oh, hello. Recognise these puppies. These are Second World War bomber seats. That one there. Is that Lancaster bomber seat?
Yeah, well, it's certainly a warplane seat. I couldn't actually categorically say what it's from.
Last time I bought one of these, I was told that it came out of a Second World War bomber. So it could be Lancaster, could be a Flying Fortress. There's various things it could be. It's even in military green, so it's definitely a military seat, that's for sure.
This desirable vintage aircrew seat is made of mixed alloy and upholstered in military green leather. Dating from the 1940s, if found to be from an RAF World War II bomber, it could be worth around £450.
So what's going to buy that today?
200?
Do it again, 250. We pay 250 for the seat in the end. I'm going to see 450 for it with some cleaning. So, easily. So it's a straightforward buy for me, that one. But we might be able to trace a little bit more history with it. That always adds to it. If we grab the van now, we'll chuck everything in.
Yeah.
I'll give you some money.
Yeah.
And we'll do that, shall we?
Yeah.